started in one store and was still called Star Office. So quite a long time around. I'm mainly working on CAD for a number formatter and the implement framework for data focus and things. What I focus on in the demo is the odd calculation with text that are always reoccurring in spreadsheets that gives troubles. Most people don't notice under there somewhere a little bit. And I'll explain, I'll show why it's not a good idea and what is implemented freshly in 4.3 that you can switch between different text conversion modes. How we interpret these textual representation of numbers actually. And I also show quickly the extension, the convert text to numbers extension that is done by Tor score here. No?
Yes.
Oh, there! Hidden in the drawing, yes. So that, that already exists since years, but well, I just show you why it makes sense to have it installed. Let's start with a little demo. Is it visible? Yeah. I have a column of values here, and let's make it a little larger. We regularly do get bug reports that calc is not calculated or not calculated correctly. Mostly, I know before opening the bug report, just because they use substrings. And for example, if you enter the sum of this looks like a value and this looks like a value, but you only get the sum of one of these values because actually this one is a string and not a value, it just looks like it. You can notice in the spreadsheet visually, because strings are usually left aligned, unless of course you change the justification. The values are right aligned. And the same for dates. If it is a value, it's right aligned. If the string is left aligned. So here in this column, we have a calculation where always to the field to the left is going to the value 111. No matter what, it's for each row, even to the dates. So you get a different date. That is 111 days in the future from the day to the left. And then for some expressions, we have counted, calculated, you get an error. And here's already the first pitfall because some versions ago, I think it was in 4.0, also this day was recognized as a date. So it is not an English CS date, but actually yielded in the 9th of April because yes, we start with the month and the day. This is not recognized anymore since we now have, language statics, languages. We now have these date acceptance patterns here that describe what actually is recognized as a pattern. And it says there has to be a slash. So dot is not working. There's an error value. These are the expected values here, and then there's a column that compares the values if it is an error and whatever, and if it's equal, it was true.
Dash
so,
works also.
What?
Dash works instead of the dot for a date.
In the English, yes, local only. Slash works.
Only
dash works only if you input the isodates, like that. This one. So then you can also use that. But you can configure it in that language page, just so show. You can add the pattern there. If you add here something like this, it will work as well. So if you look the same document in English, Great Britain locale. From the first sight, it looks equal. So, no problem. potentially press control, I have no. Usually you have that on memory calculator because documents simply load much faster, especially if you have a lot of formulas. But you can have these pitfalls also. So when you're migrating documents from Microsoft Excel, it makes sense to have at the beginning set this setting to always recalculate to spot some error or spot differences in the calculation. You also notice that Calc is simply trying to interpret these string values. For example, here we have the dot as a decimal separator, also here, and the comma as a group or thousand separator. And here I switched it in the input. We have a dot as a group separator and a decimal comma separator, but Calc notices this. That the group separator comes first and still produces the correct number. So, but I would say this is by accident that these things work. Might be that some locals have combinations that don't work. So the only error you notice is here with this string field in this example, because in the Great Britain local, your first day, then the month, as we have first the month and then the day. So the actually calculated date is something different. Now, getting... This is now a German logo, German and Germany. As before, it looks very nice because we just want the calculated values. When we recalculate everything, get only three errors. Because in Germany we have the comma separator. So this is not the number that it was before anymore. It's quite different than from what we had before, just three magnitudes larger. And the same for the date. This is not another German date, for example, but this is a German date. So we actually get very different calculations. calculations, you can adjust it depending on in which locale you load the document. Always the same document, just the different locales. So when you pass around the document to other people in your company in other countries, they actually calculate different results from what you intended, whatever. Now, most reasons why the end up strings in the document is because you paste some text from HTML, websites, whatever, and it was not recognized during the input to be a number because of, I don't know, other strings following, or the text was set to text before, like your form cells. You set just the text. If even if you put a valid number, it will be text after. Now, what we have since 4.3 is under the calc settings formula. We have these detailed calculation settings that existed already before. Custom details. And this is why I call this almost hidden features, because probably you wouldn't know this. Except you can enable OpenCL or some formula computation to extremely speed up calculations, but it's still a little bit of experimental feature. You have the conversion from text to number, which per default, because it was the old behavior from all versions also since OpenOffice .org, is convert also locally, which means we end up with these string calculations. We have different modes here now. The default convert also local dependent. Convert only unambiguous means we only calculate these strings where it is exactly identifiable what that string could be, which means no floating point values, for example, because the Smith separator may differ. Only integer values, only scientific numbers without the separator, and only ISO dates and times. So when you switch that on, you get, for example, for these values that include dates and separator, get an error value when you calculate these. And also for this date, that is not an ISO string, you already get an error. The ISO date is then reoptimized. So that's an easy way to spot the most obvious errors in the document, data errors, bad input. Going back to the option. That was convert only unambiguous. Then we have a setting treat as zero, which means every string you use for calculation will produce the zero value. So, which sometimes under some circumstances may help. But you see that almost everything you calculate with the string produces zero, which is just the number 111 we had above. And of course, that's the day number 111 from the null day on, so that doesn't make much sense there, but changes the calculations. That's actually introduced because we have this odd behavior of the sum, which always ignores string values like this one. So actually, if you calculate calculate this plus this, it's the same value. Sometimes people expected that. Doesn't make much sense to me, but people wanted it, so it's in. And we have the last setting, this generated value error, which for me is the very best settings you can have for new documents or even for migrated documents, because you immediately spot every error that could result from string conversions on the fly. Because we know value, even not these isodates, or also not if you have an integer, not an integer. Integer looking like a string, they all produce value error. So to me, that's the best setting you can have. It has also the advantage that, of course, once these numbers are already recognized using the input and converted to a number, when calculating the document, they don't have to be interpreted again, so it's much faster. So, now to the very nice extension. You can find it on the extensions LibreOffice.org site. Extensions. You can just search for CT2M, convert text to numbers. You will find it here. I already installed it. Currently it says that warning, product not released in over 1 year, may not longer be maintained. Don't get confused by that, it works perfectly. It just needs a new app or whatever, or we need to remove it. It adds this icon to your toolbar. Clicking on that icon for the current sheet, that's looking a little bit large. This resolution. So you can either select, for example, if you know that only values in one column, you can select that volume and set the current selection, or you just go whole sheet and do the sheet for sheet, or individual cells where you can do both the cell values here. You can specify the decimal separator, which is comma or dot here, with the asterisk is the default separator of your current logarithm. You can specify whether you want to convert text dates as well, which would be these two. And the action, whether you want to convert or just want to see what would be converted. You can highlight the cells, which actually doesn't belong to the cell. And it pastes also the list of cell addresses to the clipboard in case you want to store it inside your document. So when we do this, check everything we want. We don't want to convert, we just want to know. You see, these are actually the cells that are problematic. We'll also notice that this was not marked because we have a dot as a set in the separator. So this actually could be any other string. Would be different if we had a comma. Start again. Yeah, that's actually that. So this extension is very useful to spot these errors and convert many values on the fly. Another trick to do this actually is mark values. And for, let's say, this is an regular expression, anything starting with anything. And in place with a font string. Check the regular expression here. Replace all. Does this. That's because the input is interpreted again as if it was input with a keyboard. So that works if we have just one volume, so that's an easy way without external extending. That's basically it. I'm at the end of my time. Just wanted to show you one thing that I was working on the last, well, months before until the 4.3 came out. Do you have just some text? You all know this language attribution. You have this long language list, and we always we ask for languages we should add because people, in, especially in language research institutes and universities, have some obscure language they want to support and write dictionaries for whatever. We have now the possibility to notice this is an input field actually. So we can actually input valid BCP47 language tags. That what I would also call a peer feature, but you will have to then help find language. Here's a pointer for more documentation about how this can be done. That's it. Any questions?
You use a language setting day in, day in.
Yeah.
And I often think about day in dash CH for Switzerland.
Yeah.
And it's often used, so CH, is this Swiss, German, or is this the German you can in Switzerland? This is always something that I ask
myself. Let's look at German in Switzerland.
Okay, so.
That there is another tech for the Swiss German.
Yeah.
I don't remember at the moment. I could look up it here.
So I ask myself, should I use D-E-D-E? If I use German without SZ, for example.
I think that would be D-E-C-H. Because there may be spell checking dictionaries that actually support it. I think they would use DECH for German in Switzerland because it's still German, just with the orthography and used in Switzerland. But I think there is even a language tag for this, not a dialect, but this real Switzerland.